Now I'm going to take you through preparation for treatment as well. So our baby has been transferred from another unit. Place the baby onto the mattress. Now we need to connect up our rectum and skin probes to the system as well. So to prepare our rectal probe, we have our reusable adapter cable. This can just be steam sterilised or wiped down with alcohol between uses. And our disposable probe, which we discarded after treatment. And we just connect these. That goes on. This rectal probe is a foam jack, and this will just go into the socket marked R on the Tecotherm unit as well. The rectal probe will need to be inserted into the baby. This will be inserted between 2 and 5 centimetres, depending on your clinical practice as well. Some units will put a little bit of tape onto the probe just to show how far we should insert it as well. So we can insert the probe into the baby. And it's just a nice idea to secure it with a little bit of tape on the inner thigh as well. So our skin probe, again we have a reusable adapter cable and the disposable probe as well. Now this has a different connector type to the rectal probe, and this will go into the system. The skin probe is not essential to the operation, it's the rectal temperature that will be feeding back to the Tecotherm Neo. But if using, we recommend that it's placed outside of the mattress, either on the forehead or on the chest as well. And this can just be secured with a little temperature sensor cover. What we need to do is wrap the baby as they're in the mattress just using our felt ties that we have. Just wrapping the baby increases the surface area that you're cooling. It just allows you to cool down quicker. And now the baby is ready for cooling as well. So now we need to go to our on-screen operation. Our main menu is still on from filling the system, and you can choose one of three modes at the top. The simplest mode to use is the servo control complete treatment mode. This will allow you to cool the baby down to target temperature as quickly as possible. Maintain that temperature for your desired time, typically 72 hours, and it will automatically rewarm the baby to normal temperature after treatment as well. To go into this, we just select servo complete treatment. It will always ask you to get a rectal probe ready and just confirm that you've got a rectal probe in place. And again, this is just because a rectal probe is feeding back to the system in this mode. Just press confirm, and we then get through to our parameters screen here as well. The default parameters for the system are always what were the parameters set by the TOBY study. You can change any of the parameters by selecting. So a typical one that changes the rewarming phase. You can increase this or decrease this using the scroll keys. So now I've changed it to 0.25 degrees per hour on the screen as well. Once you're happy with your settings, press apply. You also now have the option within our software to save that treatment profile. So So your settings will be defaulted every time you turn that Tecotherm on. So that saves you even more time in starting treatment as well. So I'm just going down and save the treatment file. And it will tell you that it's going to create you a new treatment profile for that. And just press yes to confirm that you want to save it. And you'll see your profile is now stored, and this will be defaulted every time you start the system. So once you're happy, press start. Again, it will show you, it will ask you to confirm that the rectal probe is in place as well. And you can confirm as well. I'm just going to run my rectal probe up. This error message here is quite important. The system will not start if the rectal probe is outside physiological range. I'm just going to warm up my probe a little bit. And once it's back within physiological range, the system will start. And you're now calling the infant. On the top of the screen, you have your set target temperature, typically 33.5 degrees. Underneath, you have your measured rectal temperature. And that's what your current rectal temperature is reading. A different colour green on the screen as well. On this side you have your mattress temperature and your skin temperature as well. Throughout treatment, the graphical display will display each of these parameters in a different colour so you can see exactly what temperature each parameter is. Throughout treatment we have a number of options. If you want to change your treatment, all your parameters of treatment, you can go in and change your settings. You can immediately start rewarming, or you can end the treatment as well. There's also an alarm check on here, which is similar to when you logged into the system. If you're worried they're not working, it will ask you to confirm that the alarms are working. If you click no, it will shut the system down. I'm just going to go back into treatment as well. Throughout treatment, we have a number of alarms operating. So we have two different types of temperature alarms. The first is if the temperature deviates from set by 0.5 degrees more or less from the set temperature. This alarm will kick in after initial cool down, so once you've reached target temperature. And this will just alert you that the system has gone out of range. The other temperature alarm we have on there is fallback mode. During cool down, this will be activated if the temperature goes out of physiological range. So between 29 and 39 degrees, you're going to fallback mode. What this means is the system will default to the last mattress temperature, but it will come out of a servo control mode and go into a constant mattress temperature mode. So you need to manage that mattress temperature. Once the temperature comes back into range, the system will automatically go back into servo control mode. Once you reach your target temperature, fallback mode will still be active on the system, but this will only kick in if it's a degree more or less than set temperature as well. The other alarm you may experience is the low fluid alarm. If this alarm occurs, you need to top up the system. We also recommend that throughout treatment that you top up every 12 hours or so because there is some evaporation loss through the system as well. So to do that, you're still in operation, you need to connect your connector back to your top roofing ports. White in the left and green on the right hand side. And just invert your bottle. Important to connect both connectors fast to the system. You will hear your alarms while you're opening. Don't worry about this. Completely normal. So once the bill has stopped falling with both connectors, we recommend that you then disconnect the left-hand connector, leave the green connector in place as well, and this will just allow more fluid to be pumped into the system as well. Once you're happy that the system is full, disconnect that wiring connector. The other thing you may experience during operation is a low flow alarm. This means there's been an interruption to the fluid being pumped around the system. This could be due to kinks in tubes or mattresses. We recommend that you check the kinks in the system. Again, you also need to make sure that that system is really full of fluids, so topping up every 12 hours as well. The other alarms that we have a power failure alarm on here. If the power is disconnected, you'll see the alarm lights up here. Once the power is re-established, you'll have the option to continue your treatment where you left off. This is really important if there's a power cut as well. Here it just takes a few moments to load up. It'll ask you, do you want to continue with your treatment or start a new one? Say yes here, we want to start. This one. The other alarm you may see is the system failure alarm. This will light up. This indicates that there's an internal fault to the system as well. So once you're ready to end treatment, if you're in complete treatment mode, this will automatically rewarm to core temperature for you. If you need to end the treatment sooner than that, you can just go to options and end treatment data. Just press select and that will take you back to the main menu. From the main menu, we have a number of options. You can export your patient data. Go to export. You need to have a USB stick plugged into the back of the system. You can export new treatment data. This will export all data since your last export of the system. You can export all treatment data, which is all the data that's been recorded to the system here, or you can select and just export the last patient you recorded to as well. Power off the system, you have to power off through the main menu. You cannot power through here in case it gets accidentally knocked. Do this, just scroll down and select power off.